Hi everybody, welcome back to Clean Slate Farm. Today we're going to talk about trimming up the strawberry plants. You have to do that every year after they bloom and after you get your strawberries. I got a lot of weeds in here, and the reason you want to do that is to let new leaves grow up and get them ready for winter. These were ravaged by Japanese beetles, so it's a real mess. But we're going to show you how to retrim those up. Stay tuned. I've got quite a mess going on here. You can see I've already trimmed some of the leaves of the strawberry plant back, but what I've got in between the rows is just tons and tons of weeds. All this stuff that I pulled out earlier just to find out what was going on. So what we're going to do is pull the weeds. This is going to take a few days. The ground is really dry right now, but we're going to pull the weeds. We're going to snip back the top of the strawberry plants. They're all dead. We had a real problem with Japanese beetles earlier, and boy, they just ravaged this and a lot of the fruit, the grapes, they got at the grapes. So let me just show you a little bit what's going on here. Pull a weed out of there. What I'm going to do is, in between the rows, I can pretty much see what's going on. So I can pull some of the weeds out of there. Get those out, and every once in a while, I'm going to run into a strawberry plant. And I'll show you what that is right here. This is the main strawberry plant. This is one of the ones that we planted earlier. This is a runner. It came off of this plant, rooted, and started another berry plant in between two others. There's another one here and another one here. Those are runners. I don't necessarily want those, but I don't want to throw them away either. So what I'm going to do is just clear everything out, strip everything down, and then we'll pull those out and we'll figure out what to do with them later. Maybe we'll expand the bed a little bit behind me or a little bit longer. Although this year we got 45 pounds of strawberries, 40, 45 pounds of strawberries. Got a freezer full of strawberries. Not sure what we're going to do with it all. But maybe we'll give some away to the local food bank around here. But that's what we're going to do. So first thing I'm going to do is just get, I got a regular pair of grass clippers. Just get in there. Snip off these. And get rid of those. I can see already down inside there, there's runners on top of, there's another one right there that wasn't planted. But I've got runners on top of runners. And look at that. A little strawberry, get that out of the way. A little strawberry blossom. Hope you can see that. So we're going to trim these back. And if it's anything like last year, they will shoot up new leaves. Matter of fact, I already see some little leaves growing around down in there. So, runner back there. It's just an absolute mess. Now, I know where the plants are, and the weeds are coming out fairly easy, but it's going to be a long road. So, I'm going to do a little bit more. We'll be back in a second. So, it's not as bad as I first thought with the weeds. I mean, there are some weeds in there, but my bigger problem is I've got too many strawberry plants. I'm looking here, and I've got one, two, three there. The runners just went nuts. One here, here. They're all over the place. So plan of action now is to get the ground moist, trim all this stuff off, get the ground moist. Okay, there's some weeds right there. Get the ground all moistened up and then dig these out and we'll transplant them somewhere. They're pretty hardy plants. They take really well. So, I mean, as you can see, they grow without anybody's help. It's practically a weed. Anyway, hey, thanks for watching the Clean Slate Farm. Going to rain any second here, so I'm going to get out of here. Thanks for watching. Thumbs up if you like these videos. Please subscribe and tell your friends too. Bye bye. We'll see you later from Clean Slate Farm.